Good afternoon to all students. Today we will discuss about the obstetric operation in the manual vacuum aspiration. So firstly, introduction. The manual vacuum aspiration is a aseptic procedure. It is a aseptic in procedure that involves the evacuation of uterine contents by the use of a handheld plastic or aspirator. Manual vacuum aspiration is a aseptic procedure. In this procedure contains by the use of hand and held plastic aspirator. A plastic aspirator is used in this procedure. Used commonly in both developed and developing countries, approximately 1 in 4 women will experience a miscarriage in her lifetime. Approximately 1 in 4 women in other countries, in developed other countries, experience a miscarriage in her lifetime. Then advantage of manual vacuum aspiration is what is the advantage of the manual vacuum aspiration? So first is the World Health Organization recommends manual vacuum aspiration for uterine evacuation. The World Health Organization recommends the manual vacuum aspiration. First is the safe, high quality, affordable, and second is the easy to learn, easy to use. It is the easy to learn how we do the manual vacuum aspiration, and easy to learn how we can provide a procedure to a woman, and small, portable, quiet, no electricity and required, ideal for performing procedure in the outpatient setting. This is the easy to performing the procedure of the outpatient department. Then indication of the manual vacuum aspiration. Indication, first is the treatment of incomplete abortion for general anesthesia up to 12 weeks. If the woman is having abortion before the abortion for a general anesthesia up to the 12 weeks, then the manual vacuum aspiration procedure have done to the woman. In first trimester, abdominal menstrual when indicated in the Mrs. abortion, general anesthesia is greater than 12 weeks. If the woman is having general anesthesia greater than 12 weeks and getting abortion, then the manual vacuum procedure should be done in the woman. Then gestational trophoblastic disease, molar pregnancy. Molar pregnancy is that means the molar pregnancy is the non-cancerous growth of cells in the side of the uterus. Then septic abortion, if the woman is have septic abortion, is that means the infected or septic abortion is greater than 12 weeks general anesthesia. Then invertible abortion is greater than 12 weeks, less than 12 weeks general anesthesia, and blightovum of embryonic gestation. So these are the indications. In the first indication, first, if the woman is having abortion less than the 12 weeks or under the general anesthesia, and in the first trimester, if the woman is having gestational trophoblastic disease or molar pregnancy. So in this condition, manual vacuum aspiration should be done in the woman. Then diagnostic. Diagnostic of this procedure, first is the endometrial biopsy. In this procedure, first diagnosis should be endometrium biopsy and dysfunctional uterine bleeding. Uterine bleeding and molar pregnancy. diagnostic, first diagnosis should be, first is the endometrial biopsy should be, endometrial biopsy should be done in the woman for the identify of the any abnormality or any bleeding or hemorrhage of a endometrium, and dysfunctional uterine bleeding if the woman is having uterine bleeding or not. In retained product of conception, then molar pregnancy. We should also assess the molar pregnancy if the woman is having non-cancerous growth of cells in her side of the uterine wall. So these are the diagnostic. Then contraindication. Contraindication that which in, is that means in which condition we can not provide the vacuum aspiration procedure. First is the termination of pregnancy. If the woman is terminate the pregnancy greater than 12 weeks, general anesthesia, because bony tissue and other body tissue is formed which is difficult to be evacuated. If the woman is having medical termination of pregnancy less than greater than the 12 weeks under the general anesthesia, in this condition the this procedure should be avoided. Then relative purulent cervicitis and pelvic infection. We should also, if the woman is having pelvic infection or cervicitis, that means the infection of the cervix. If the woman is having purulent discharge or purulent infection in the cervix, then in that condition, the manual vacuum aspiration procedure should not be provided. Then coagulation disorder, if the woman is having coagulation disorder, then in this condition, the procedure should be not done. Then equipment use. The required equipment of this procedure, first is the manual vacuum aspiration. First is the manual vacuum aspiration kit. Then second is the thermal syringe. Thermal syringe is also known as a manual vacuum aspirator. Thermal syringe and cannula, then cannula. So this equipment should be in the manual vacuum module. First is the thermal syringe, second is the cannula, and in the instrument first is the Valsalam or Tenalclon instrument. In the instruments, first is the Valsalam. First is the Valsalam and sponge holding. Second is the sponge holding. Second instrument should be sponge holding, then kidney disc and Hager dilators, uterine sound and Cosco or Sims speculum. So these are the instrument. In the instruments, first is the Valsalam speculum, and second is the sponge holding, and kidney disc, Hager dilators, and uterine sound, and Sims speculum also. Then preparation of client of before the applying procedure. This procedure of how we can prepare a patient for this procedure. First is the explain procedure to patient and obtain a written or verbal consent. We should explain the procedure about the manual vacuum aspiration, what is the advantage, disadvantage, and contraindication, and in case of this procedure, we should be deeply explained to the patient and her family. Then priming the cervix with agents such as a prostaglandin around 3 hours prior to procedure. We should provide the prostaglandins about the 3 hours before the procedure and reduce the risk of cervical trauma and hemorrhage. Then pain management. In the pain management, first the goal should be reduce pain and anxiety. We should try to reduce the pain and anxiety of a patient. And psychological pain, anxiety, fear and apprehension, cervical pain due to dilatation. then uterine cramping due to manipulation. Then timing, drug must be most effective at the time of the procedure. In the mostly drugs is effective during the time of this procedure. Administer drug 30 to 45 minutes before the procedure. We should administer the drug before the start of the procedure 30 to 40 minutes. Then pharmacological management. In the pharmacological management, anxiolytic drugs are provided. The anxiolytic agents, the diazepam is provided to relieve the anxiety and sedatives. The analgesics are also provided, such as the ibuprofen. Ibuprofen is the non-steroid anti-inflammatory drugs which reduce the pain. Then local anesthesia for paracervical block using iodocaine or prethidine. These are the local anesthetic drugs. Then in the non-pharmacological management, gentle respectfully interaction and communication. Non-pharmacological means we should communicate the patient with the gently and mannerfully, and verbal support and reassurance. And verbal support, we should provide the verbal and communicate her family members. Then gentle smooth operative technique, we should apply the procedure gently or smoothly. Then can supplement but not replace medication. We should not replace the medication during the procedure. Is that means the all care and the drugs should be provided before the starting of the procedure. So this is the procedure of manual vacuum aspiration. The manual vacuum aspiration is the septic procedure. If the woman is having a miscarriage or abortion before the 12 weeks, then the procedure should be done in the woman. So this is all about of the manual vacuum aspiration. Okay, thank you, students.